Good job, buddy.
Mm-hmm. You're doing
it. This one's gonna smell like sap. Be careful, you'll get sap on these because
that was a green tree.
Hey, sister.
This is the beginning of the chicken coop.
Yeah.
So.
The baby chickens could fit so easily.
I built that frame in the garage so that I could get it all nice and flat and square. And now I'm gonna find the exact spot to put it and then put it up on these pillars. And then I can start framing up the walls and the floor and all that stuff out here. So we're getting closer, I think. Whoop, you okay? All right, good job, bud. All right, so I got the framing of the floor complete. So all I gotta do is sheet it and start framing the walls up and get this thing finished. I reinforced the corners there and then reinforced the framing in the middle. So it should be pretty sturdy. Pretty happy with this actually. All right, so that little floor coating turned out real nice. It'll give it a nice, smooth, slick surface, so it'll be easier to clean the coop. And looks like everything is moving along nicely, so it's time to start framing up some of these walls and get this thing finished. Stay tuned. pull that wall back. Here, actually, I want you to do the leveling, and then I can put the screw in to hold this in place. All right, so here's the next phase of the nesting boxes. So we have basically 12 inch boxes here. And then I left this one a little bigger because this is just gonna be like a storage compartment for, you know, gloves or just anything that's needed for being out here in the chicken coop, just little things. So I'll come in here afterwards and I'll put pieces of plywood in here and kind of section them off, and then the door is going to actually, no, it's going to lift down, so we're going to lay the door down, be able to get into the chicken nesting boxes, and then we'll put the door back up. So far so good. And one thing I think I'm proud of the most out of all of this is that that's all the waste I have up to this point. So my whole goal with this thing is to build it with as little waste as possible, being that the cost of lumber is so outrageous. You want to make good use of every little piece of wood that you have. And so far, so good. So on to the next phase. All right, well, it's the next morning. Bubba's gonna play a little baseball while I continue to work on this. I got pretty far yesterday. I finished framing in the nesting boxes, got the trusses hung, and the first sheet of plywood up there. So today I've got a lot of little punch list items I got to get done on the inside. Right now I'm going to be coating this piece of plywood with a nice porch paint, just like this, so that it can go here, and then the perches go above that, so when the chickens poop, it goes down onto this board, and then we just scoop it down into a bucket right here and use it for compost or whatever. And then this provides a kind of a box for the bunnies who are going to be underneath it, and then their entry point is around the side there. So a lot of little punch list items to get started on first this morning, but I'm hoping, if everything goes well, to get all that stuff done and then get it sited today. And then we can start painting the outside and get it buttoned up. All right, the first vent is framed in. Looks good, fits nice and tight. And I'm gonna put another one in on that side so that we got airflow going through. But so far, so good. Some headway here. I got the roof all buttoned up and I'm starting the siding now. The one thing I'm thankful of is I watched a video on, you know, just building a chicken coop and whatnot, and it's very important, if you don't understand framing, to make sure that your studs are 16 on center. That way when you go to hang the siding, everything lines up on a stud and it just fits nice and neatly. So now we're gonna do this side. the challenging piece is doing this by yourself. And so I need like a third hand, but what I ended up doing, because I got to get the siding up and then take a pencil and draw in the windows. And so I temporarily have to put it up there. So while it's up there, I came up with these little guys. I'm gonna use my little buddies here. And then I can set the siding on there. It's right where it needs to be. I can put a couple screws in there just to hold it temporarily. And then take it back down and cut out those holes there. So far so good.
Good. Yeah.